Esther. Hey, Kim, how's the holiday party planning going?
I am so stressed. Sometimes I just need to light some candles.
Tell me about it, with the movie and the whole family in town?
It's all about self-care, isn't it?
We're givers, Kim.
And we gotta make time for ourselves, you know?
If you're not there for yourself, how can you be there for your family, right?
Exactly.
I could feel you guys' energies. I could look at you. I could see you. I can know that this squad is like handpicked and fire, electric, smart, beautiful, lovely, energized, divine. How many people here feel like they have an inner divinity? Would you raise your hands if you feel like you have an inner divinity? How many people feel like they have an inner God inside of them here? Mm-hmm. How many people, is it?
Raise
today a little bit more. raise
your hand if you don't feel like you have God inside of you. Why don't you feel like you have God inside you? Interesting. So it feels like if you say that you're divine and you have God inside you, that what would you feel that we have God inside of us? So I could adjust that statement. How many people feel that we have God inside of us?
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
Okay guys, so check this out. Kanye West is already plotting a sequel to his Jesus is King album. Yeezy posted a photo of himself and Dr. Dre on Twitter, announcing part 2 is in the works. Ye and Dre, Jesus is King part 2 coming soon. He wrote on Monday, November 18th. Kanye's original Jesus is King LP was released on October 25th, following multiple delays. The Good Music founder planned to drop his 9th studio album, previously titled Yandi, in 2018, but scrapped that idea in favor of a gospel-style project.
October 25th, 2019, Kanye West released an album and IMAX movie called Jesus is King. There is much occult symbolism to be deciphered here. Let's begin with the connection to James Tyrrell's Roden Crater. Roden Crater, located in the Painted Desert region of northern Arizona, is an unprecedented large-scale artwork created within a volcanic cinder cone by light and space artist James Tyrrell. First, I think it's a good idea to begin by taking a look at the who before we look at the what. Who is James Tyrrell? James Tyrrell is a New Age occult artist. He once had an exhibit called Aten Rain at Guggenheim's iconic Frank Lloyd Wright Rotunda. Aten is the disk of the sun in ancient Egyptian mythology and originally an aspect of the god Ra. The sun god Ra, or Horus, was depicted with a falcon head. Remember this, as we will come back to it later. Oh, and by the way, it should be noted that James Tyrrell was awarded the National Medal of Arts by President Obama in 2013. Now that we have established that James Tyrrell, the Who, is known for his artwork, which displays New Age spiritualism and depicts pagan gods, let's move on to the what. I find it very interesting that Kanye chose a sculpture in the desert to represent his album, Jesus is King, since Matthew 24:26 gives us a warning about false Christs appearing during the end times when it declares, "Wherefore, if they shall say unto you, Behold, he is in the desert, go not forth. Behold, he is in the secret chambers, believe it not." Roden Crater was constructed inside of a volcano. I find this very interesting as well, since the pagan god Vulcan is the god of fire, including the fire of volcanoes, deserts, and metalworking. That's no coincidence. The worship of Vulcan consisted of humans being thrown into a fiery volcano or bonfires created in honor of the god. Vulcan is also connected to the sun god because of the fire and the resulting light given off by the sun. In fact, according to Terrell, Roden Crater is a controlled environment for the experiencing and contemplation of light. We can clearly see how the connection of this crater to Vulcan, the sun god, fire, and light symbolically connects it to Lucifer, the light bearer, or Satan, who is also known as Apollyon or Abaddon, the king of the bottomless pit, found in Revelation chapter 9, verse 11. In fact, when we look closely at Revelation chapter 9, we see even more symbolic connections to Roden Crater and Lucifer. Verse 1 declares, "And the fifth angel sounded, and I saw a star fall from heaven unto the earth, and to him was given the key of the bottomless pit." When a celestial body falls from heaven unto the earth, the impact creates a crater in the earth's surface. This is a reference to Roden Crater. Verse 1 also tells us that the angel who fell to the earth was given a key. You will notice that Roden Crater is designed to look like a keyhole. This crater represents the door or gateway for the fallen angel to be released from the bottomless pit onto the earth. Revelation 9, verse 2 declares, "And he opened the bottomless pit, and there arose a smoke out of the pit, as the smoke of a great furnace, and the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit." This description bears an uncanny resemblance to the description of a volcano eruption. When you enter the Roden Crater structure, there is a bench outlining the interior, which allows visitors to face an elliptical sky cutout, also called an oculus. The word oculus means eye. This is why Kanye West decided to release his movie Jesus is King at IMAX theaters as a reference to the all-seeing eye. Interestingly enough, James Terrell also had another art display called the Tall Glass and Wide Glass series, which were on display at the Pace Gallery in London and at the Los Angeles County Museum of Art. It included this rendering of a floating pyramid. Therefore, in James Terrell's art, we have a representation of the ancient Egyptian and Masonic emblem, the pyramid and the eye, which represents the eye of Horus. We know that Kanye West is connected with Jay-Z and Rockefeller Records, who also used the symbolism of the pyramid and eye. In fact, you may remember not too long ago, Kanye West wore a huge gold chain with the pendant of the falcon-headed god Horus on it. This connects back to James Turrell's exhibit called Aten Rain, which depicted the sun god Horus or Ra as well. Here is a picture of Kanye West at the Tutankhamun in the Golden Age of the Pharaohs exhibition at the Discovery Times Square Exposition in New York. It is clear then, by Kanye's choice to use artist James Turrell and his artwork, which is undoubtedly connected with ancient Egyptian gods, to represent his album, Jesus is King, shows that Kanye West has not changed his tune. He is nothing more than a wolf in sheep's clothing. In this video, author Anthony Browder, who just so happens to come from Chicago like Kanye and Obama, is promoting the false Messiah propaganda of how the story of Jesus is a copy of the story of Osiris, Isis, and Horus.
The most obvious symbol of the capital of the wealthiest and most powerful nation in human history is an object that is known as the Washington Monument. That symbol is an ancient African symbol which represents the resurrection of an African king named Asar, whose name was later changed by the Greeks to Osiris.
Browder falsely claims that the Washington Monument is a symbol of resurrection, when in actuality, it is a symbol of erection and reproduction, as it represents Osiris's penis. He then tries to tie the story of the supposed virgin, Isis, who used magic to put the pieces of her dead husband, Osiris, back together, including his penis, which is the Egyptian obelisk, and then used that phallic symbol to impregnate herself with Horus, the sun god, who was born on December 25th, a representation of the false Christ. Kanye's connection with Horus, who is depicted as a false Messiah figure by occultists and the all-seeing eye, clearly shows us that his claim of being a Christian is nothing more than a ruse to fool the public.
If you see somebody slipping, you tell them. They be coming at me like, why are you so judgmental? It ain't for me to judge, but I'm gonna say what I see.
It should be noted that there are even many so-called professing Christian pastors who are actually practicing witches and New Age occultists who preach from the pulpit every Sunday, hiding under the guise of titles like Reverend, Pastor, and Bishop. 2 Corinthians chapter 11 verses 14 through 15 declare, "And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works." Which leads us to our next clue concerning Kanye West's Jesus is King album. You will notice that the color blue is given significance. The color blue is associated with everything connected to this album. Blue is the first of the three primary colors, and it is the color of the throat chakra. Supposedly, blue connects you with the divine, and it is the color that is associated with heaven. According to those who practice the occult science of using these so-called psychic energy centers of the body, the throat chakra is the key to manifesting your desires. Again, this connects back to Kanye's use of the color blue and the key symbolism for this album. The use of the throat chakra is significant also since Kanye West is a rapper or artist who uses singing or vocals in his music. Vocal cords are folds of tissue in the throat that are key in creating sounds through vocalization, a clear reference to the use of the throat chakra. Ezekiel chapter 28 verse 13 describes the meticulous workmanship of Lucifer's vocal cords. Thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. Every precious stone was thy covering, the sardis, topaz, and the diamond, the beryl, the onyx, and the jasper, the sapphire, the emerald, and the carbuncle, and gold. The workmanship of thy tabrets and of thy pipes was prepared in thee in the day that thou was created. We also know that in the past, Kanye himself has posed as a false Christ figure and as a fallen angel as well. At one point in his career, Kanye even claimed that he had sold his soul to the devil.
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
Kanye West and Joel Osteen, they are at it again, this time at baseball's cathedral, Yankee Stadium. TMZ first reported the latest team-up, saying the duo hopes to fill the stadium in the Bronx to the brim. Lakewood Church confirms the idea is out there, but says they're still ironing out the details here. And get this, Yankee Stadium seats more than 54,000 people. That's 10,000 more than Lakewood Church. Yeezy's two events there filled that without a problem last month.
I have known all along that the reason why I ended up being who I am and have been carried by the divine is because I had a special relationship.
We are excited that John Gray and Avinder Gray are going to be your pastors. And I really believe that John and Avinder have always been anointed. But the anointing that is going to fall on them now that they're senior pastors is going to do amazing damage to the kingdom of God. So I'm excited about it.
Welcome to First Trinity Unity Community Church of the United States. How can we feed you today?
Who's teaching?
Pastor Wilkes.
No, I'm not so crazy about him.
Oh, I meant Pastor Johnson, of course. Sorry for the mix-up.
That's more like it. Now look, I don't want any of that Old Testament business today. I want to focus on the New Testament.
Well, of course, sir. The Old Testament God is me.
I mean, he is a lot happier now, so let's focus on the present.
Certainly.
I want some creative illustrations. I want to laugh a little bit, but not too much. I want my communion crackers broken for me with 100% with 100% natural grape juice. I know that stuff last week was from Ken. You think that's honoring to God?
No, sir. Of course not.
I didn't think so. And I want to feel encouraged and uplifted and affirmed this week. And look, I want some healing for my bunion. And I don't want to be challenged too much, just a little bit, okay? Because I'm challenged enough during work.
Certainly. This is a safe place. A happy place.
I'd be a lot happier if you had something in the fifth row or so.
Certainly.
That's what I'm talking about.
Eating grass may seem like an unorthodox way to show your religious devotion. But for members of the Rabboni Center Ministries in Hurunkura, South Africa, grazing on greenery is a key part of their spiritual practice. Pastor Lesejo Daniel, who runs the ministry, believes it brings worshippers closer to God, with some members of the congregation even claiming it has cured them of serious health defects.
I want to lead people to a place they've never been today. You are here in this church, but I'm taking you on a journey. Wake up!
The pastor uses his services to lead his followers on a spiritual journey.
I'm taking you to hell. I'm leading you to hell. See how hell looks like. We're coming back. Let's come back. Are you hungry? Sip. Be quiet. Okay, go and eat.
And while the group's unusual eating habits have attracted controversy online, members of the ministry have no plans to stop the practice.
If Jesus turned water into wine, we are turning the grass into spaghetti and beans.
Because of deceitfulness, lust excited by deceit, and deceitful influences seducing to sin. Deceitful lusts, by a paragram, are being applied to the agape love feasts, the communal celebration in the church in which food, fellowship, and worship is shared in an assembly. Base men have transformed this church celebration into seductive revels, through things pleasing to the eye, with the power to attract, bewitch, and captivate under a magic spell.
Music, the lights, the crowds. It looks like a rock concert. And the lines around the block are enough to make any nightclub envious. But this is church.
They are testing, tempting, and provoking many by arousing sexual desires and influencing others to do things that are unwise and morally wrong. This is done to cheat and beguile. They are distracting people's attention by amusing and charming them to divert them from the truth that they may be deceived.
How far have we fallen? As a church, you know, I've been a long time fan of Hillsong's music, but this Hillsong church is clearly under the direction of the New World Order.
The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist.
Recently, Kanye appeared on Jimmy Kimmel to promote his new album.
Our gift to you, Brooklyn, is a visit from Mr. Kanye West.
You will notice the signs in the background that read, East Gate. Ezekiel chapter 11, verses 1 through 2, speaks about evil in high places and connects that evil with the East Gate of the Lord's house when it declares, "Moreover, the Spirit lifted me up and brought me unto the east gate of the Lord's house, which looketh eastward. And behold, at the door of the gate, 25 men, among whom I saw Jazaniah the son of Azur, and Pelatiah the son of Benaiah, princes of the people. Then said he unto me, Son of man, these are the men that devise mischief and give wicked counsel in this city." When introducing Kanye, Kimmel mentions giving the people of Brooklyn in the East a gift from the West. And then Kanye West walks out to promote his album, Jesus is King.
You've done so much to welcome us to the East Coast. We have a thank you gift from the West Coast. And not only is this a gift from the West, it quite literally is a West. Our gift to you, Brooklyn, is a visit from Mr. Kanye West.
When describing the return of Messiah, Matthew 24:27 declares, "For as the lightning cometh out of the east and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be." Therefore, once again, Kanye is being placed in the position of a false Christ figure as he walks out on stage to the music, Jesus Walks.
You, Brooklyn, is a visit from Mr. Kanye West.
There is something else in control here, like the evil in high places that we discussed earlier. Now let's go back to that line by Kanye, where he compares himself to Unbreakable and Mr. Glass.
Unbreakable, what you thought they call me, Mr. Glass?
The mention of the movies Unbreakable and Mr. Glass are extremely important, as it also points us to the wickedness in high places and Ephesians 6:12, which declares, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places."
Hi guys, I can barely believe what I walked into in a Christian meeting a couple of weeks ago. And this is not the first time this has happened in a Christian church or organization here in Jerusalem. And I just despair at the deception, the counterfeit spirit, the kundalini evil that is coming in to our buildings and, you know, into the hearts of people who are perhaps striving to know God. But what's even more worrying is that there's no shepherds to look out for them. I'm going to show you the footage that I took when I walked into this meeting. And it, as you'll see, it's all about birthing. This kundalini spirit is the most disturbing thing I have ever walked into, especially in a place that's Christian. So I show you this, you know, please turn it off if it disturbs you, because it's very disturbing. But this is demonic, this is evil, and I show you this to warn you to stay well away from this type of thing. It is not Christianity, it is the New Age Kundalini Antichrist spirit.
Bethel TV. There's a great deception coming, folks. This being drunk in the spirit.
These people are under the influence of a cruel form of hypnotism, in which their psyche is broken down to leave them vulnerable to the power of suggestion and the manipulation of demonic spirits. This also seemed to have a specific goal into making them reenact the birthing process of a woman.
Oh, I sense a lot of angelic activity in the room tonight. You know, the giving of birth is accompanied by celebration. And I can't prove this to you, but I believe there are angels that come to watch what God's birthing a new thing. And that's the old father.
Declare that these babies will be born. And the dragon shall not.
more strange than not was that this was just a few days after September the 23rd this year, when all the people across the world were talking about this Revelation 12 sign. And as you just heard, the dragon not catching and devouring the babies, that's a direct quotation from that passage. And of course it includes that birthing, this imitative magic, it seems, of corrupting these Christian people and making them enact through these familiar deceptive spirits this birthing action.
Illuminized Freemasonry has adopted this picture of the first family of paganism as the formula by which they intend to produce their Masonic Christ, or Antichrist, on the world scene. Masons believe that the divine child, the Masonic Christ, will be conceived and born on the spiritual plane, and that conception and delivery will be transferred to the physical plane.
In fact, there was a number of desecrations that took place with the Mekadeshet festival during this period of time in Jerusalem. It seemed like a sustained attack from the enemy. And what's worse is these young, influential people are caught right in the middle of it.
Now, the basic question that we're asking in this documentary is, why are these manifestations so similar to Eastern religions and Hinduism and the Kundalini cults, and yet they're not found in scripture, they're not found in the Bible, they're not found in classical Christianity at all? Now, this all began with Rodney Howard Brown imparting a new anointing into a bunch of leaders, and they spread it around the world.
The Kundalini spirit, which is a serpent spirit that has been brought into the Western culture or Western world through many Pentecostal preachers who, my friend, they are very charismatic. They have been hungry for power, and it has opened them up to this fraudulent counterfeit, which they attribute to being the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, my friend, is the mind of God. He is the communicator of heaven, and he does not make a fool out of you. He does not make a scene out of you. This is the channeling, the summoning of these evil spirits. Oftentimes is through music. Because why? Music sets the atmosphere, and oftentimes people tend to relax and they empty themselves out. They really become more vulnerable to being open to this demonic spirit. The Bible clearly teaches us, beloved, John said, do not believe every spirit.
Yeah, some sad news out of Los Angeles today. It was confirmed this morning that the 20-year-old son of hip-hop star Dr. Dre was found dead in his home on Saturday. Now, several reports say that Andre Young Jr. returned home Saturday morning after a night out. They also say that Young's mother found him unresponsive later on that morning. She called 911. Those reports have not been confirmed yet, and the cause of death has yet to be determined by the coroner's office. We did, however, get a statement from Andre Young Sr.'s publicist. She said that Dr. Dre is mourning the loss of his son and asking everyone to respect their privacy and grief, and certainly our thoughts with Dr. Dre and his family on a real, real terrible day for them.
So you're trying to say that they put the work in, so that's why they have to benefit.
That's
so what about the, everybody else that's like, do you think they're the only ones putting in the work?
Nah, I mean, everybody bent over backwards, kissed the little ass, know what I mean, and got where they wanted to be and all that. But sacrificing a loved one, and I mean, I'm not feeling all that.
It's not like they know they're going to sacrifice somebody.
No,
it's once you agree to it and you start to praying to whatever they pray to, then you got to give up a soul. You don't know what soul is going to be. It ain't going to be yours, but it's going to be one close to you.
And then when you give up that soul, that means you're guaranteed to go to the top.
Yes, sir.
just metal. That's what I always thought of them.
But they're not. They're living things with souls like ours. And at once I spoke to one.
Look, in a few minutes there are going to be feds all over this place, and I don't want them finding a holy grail.
You know that story we were all told as children about a giant asteroid that struck the Earth millions of years ago and wiped out the dinosaurs?
Vaguely.
We were wrong. This metal caused the great extinction.
A rare earth metal. Molecularly unstable. Industrial uses? None.
It's the Holy Grail. Transformium. That's what we're calling it.
Focus grouped. Catchy. Trademarked.
Yeah. This is the greatest advance in modern physics. It's a programmable matter.
Now we can begin to give it instructions.
We can change anything into anything.
Sensual almost, don't you think? You like music? The pill. Perhaps something a little more violent?
Thank you. try to get up.
They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Luke 10:19 declares, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." In Revelation 6, verses 12 through 17, "And I beheld, when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood, and the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs, when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, Fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand?" We know that Satan is described as a lion in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. However, the true lion is the Messiah, who is the Lion of the tribe of Judah, found in Revelation chapter 5, verse 5, which declares, "And one of the elders saith unto me, Weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, hath prevailed to open the book, and to loose the seven seals thereof." We are living in very dark and deceitful times, friends. The wicked in high places are using their power and pulling the wires of their puppets in order to prepare the entire world to worship their false Messiah.
Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,